is the forecourt of the Burlington Hotel on Dublin's south side, which tonight is the venue for one of the sports and social highlights of the year, the Bank of Ireland GEA All-Stars for football and hurling. It's the night when the players who've been meeting each other on the field all the year get a chance to meet in more relaxed circumstances for a drink and for a chat. But of course, it is something much more important than that. It is also the night when the best footballers and hurlers of the year are honoured. Now, we already know the football team. The hurling team will be revealed a little bit later on. And to that end, I'm sure there's great anticipation down in Galway, the All-Ireland champions. Also in Tipperary and Offaly, the provincial champions, they'll be hoping to be amongst the awards. And in Antrim, where there will be great hope that their efforts in 1988 are honoured as well. Whether they will or not, we will see a little bit later on. But for the moment, Ger Canning has been meeting some of the people arriving here to the Burlington for tonight's presentation.
Conor Hayes, you've been through all this before, but it's a very big night for the players, isn't it?
It is, yeah. It's more nerve-wracking this year for the hurlers because it's a last-minute job in that we won't know until, I suppose, last minute, really, who actually gets the position.
Have you thought much about it?
I haven't really, no. As you said, I've been through it before, so if I get one, I'll be delighted, obviously. But if I don't, well, I won't be that too disappointed. You know, I think that the three that are nominated for each position, each fellow is equally deserving of that position. So as I said, if I get it, I'll be delighted. But if not, well,
it's very nice now to come here and knowing you've won the award. It's a bit tense now when you're sitting down waiting to see who wins it. So hopefully the best luck to all the players in the hurling today.
I believe your wife is just as tense. Baby's on the way, I believe.
Yes, hopefully now she's sitting at home watching this and maybe I'll bring her on a bit quicker.
Oh yes, Gerald, there's always a great interest in the All-Star Awards in New York. But of course this year there's absolutely tremendous interest because the All-Stars are going to play in New York as a curtain raiser to the National League final on May 14th. So we're looking forward to an extremely big day on that occasion.
The preparations are going well?
Everything seems to be going very well and I'm very confident that we're going to be very successful.
And Paul McKillen, it's a big night for Antrim as well. You have three players nominated in the hurling team. Full of anticipation, I'm sure.
Yes, that's a wee bit nervous, you know. And I'm sure it'll be happier up in the north.
You'd be happier in Croke Park, I suppose.
You would.
But this does reflect the great progress Antrim hurling has made in the last couple of years.
It does, yes. Well, three have been nominated and not there. Even Ulster, you know, another one, County Down. Yeah, that's a progress, you know, very good.
So the scene is set then for what we know will be a gala night. So let's go into the main banquet hall where the hostess for the evening is Eileen Dunn.
Agus a gwein uisle, an ish karamid falta rev or niana specialta tronona. I'd now ask you to rise and welcome our special guest this evening, Mr. Liam Mulville, Ord Stjurahor, Cumann Lough Class Gael, and Mr. John Dowling, Uachtaráin, Cumann Lough Class Gael. We also greet our host this evening, Mr. Frank O'Rourke, Deputy Chief Executive Bank of Ireland, and our guest of honour on Taoiseach, Mr. Charles J. Haughey, TD. The Football and Hurling All-Star Award scheme was first introduced in 1971. It was under a different sponsor in those days. And in the intervening 18 years, well, it has continued to grow in prestige. The selection of the football and the hurling teams each year has always been met with great public debate, a little bit of controversy along the way too. But the players themselves will tell you that apart from actually winning an All-Ireland or Provincial Championship medal, well, an All-Star Award is the most eagerly sought after. The task of picking those awards falls to the All-Stars Executive Committee, And they've spent the last few months buried in the bowels of the Burlington Hotel in private deliberation. We've had the odd glass of water and a little bit of dried bread thrown in just to keep them going. Well, the selection is done by a secret ballot from the original nominations, which was made by the Gaelic Games correspondents from all over the country. And in the case of the hurling team, even the committee members themselves don't know what the final result is, or at any rate, they're not supposed to know what the final result is. Well, the results of their deliberations, and of course, the very reason that we're here tonight, we'll be getting to very shortly. But first, though, it's my great pleasure to introduce you to your host here this evening, that is the Deputy Chief Executive of the Bank of Ireland, Mr. Frank O'Rourke.
Ahishig, a Oakdron, Cumanlu Class Gael, a Guineusla, a Skokor, the Aaron, Farum Falcha Rolf, Falcha Stock, Gudi Ihan a Priev Curry, Mila Nigaid, Octas a Hocht. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to extend a particularly warm welcome to Antishuk Charles J. Hawhey. And I would like to say to you, Taoiseach, how delighted we are to see you so fully recovered from your illness. And to say also how very much we appreciate the honour you pay us all, the association, the players, the organising committees, the bank, and our guests by your attendance here this evening. We appreciate it very much. A very special welcome to John Dowling, attending this All-Star Award banquet for the first time as President of Cumanlu Class Gael. We are all aware of the dedication and commitment to the ideals of the association which has brought you, John, to the presidency of the association. We extend to you every good wish for success in the challenging times ahead. Welcome to our other friends from the association, the past presidents, the officials from the counties and provinces, and a specially warm welcome to Archdurahor Liam Mulvihill and his colleagues from Croke Park. Welcome also to all of our guests from press, radio and television, and in particular, welcome to the members of the steering and selection committees. I would like to assure them that we appreciate their tremendous support and participation in this scheme. This is the 18th year of the All-Star Awards. The publicity which it receives brings with it at times criticisms and differences of view. Whilst we might all wish for the quiet life in these matters, it is essential for a national scheme that it does arouse public interest. And inevitably, that means, on occasion, critical analysis. I would like to say that we welcome this public and media interest. The scheme has evolved over the years and can benefit from the careful consideration that constructive criticism can bring. This is the 10th year of Bank of Ireland involvement. We believe very strongly in the principles of the awards scheme, and we are very proud to be associated with it. Tonight, we honour the Gaelic Athletic Association and especially the players. I am delighted that of those nominated, 78 players are present. Only 30 will receive awards, but I hope all will understand that we are gathered this evening to pay tribute and to congratulate all of them for their sporting and playing achievements in 1988. Taoiseach, a Gaoine Uaisle, Fáilte is Fiche Roimh Gach Aonair, Tá Súlagam, Go Mbeidh an Oíche Agaibh Ar Fad. Go raibh amach.
Well now, ladies and gentlemen, we come to the main business of the evening, which is the presentation of the 1988 All-Star Awards. And first, it's to football. Now, it was a year which saw some new faces along the way, but largely I think it was something of an action replay of the previous year's championship, as Meath and Cork made their way to the All-Ireland final with plenty of drama along the way.
Sucked into midfield, but Mick Kennedy has followed. This is Gillick transferring to Hayes. Open space in front of him, pursued by Tim O'Driscoll, about to come into shot. A great goal! He can lay it in for Dennis Allan. Oh, it's a great goal!
But here's a chance for Eugene Hughes in front of the goal. Can he finish?
down into space. They waited for it, weren't expecting it. McHale, the shot, a goal! David Beggy breaks for Colm O'Rourke. Beggy moves out of his way and O'Rourke chips it over for his third point.
To make the presentation to the Football All-Stars, would you welcome again, please, Mr. Frank O'Rourke, and he is accompanied by the President of the Gaelic Athletic Association, John Dowling, and our very special guest here tonight, an Taoiseach, Charles J. Haughey. Well, now, first in goal is a player who was 11 years a senior player this month, but at one stage it was feared that his career might be over after a serious car accident. The first award goes to Paddy Linden of Monaghan.
The opposition was stiff, but there can hardly be a more popular winner than Paddy Linden of Monaghan, picking up his first Bank of Ireland All-Star Award tonight.
At right full back is a player who is the recipient, and joins a select group of players indeed, who is the recipient of an automatic choice, as he was the sole nominee in the position. It's the second award in this berth for Robbie O'Malley of Meath.
Yes, another popular winner. And with Robbie's award is a chance to admire the first of the Gran Canaria suntans. Robbie, of course, has just been holidaying with the Meath party. We're delighted to see him here. Player who got in here on a late flight indeed.
I should mention at this point, ladies and gentlemen, that we are especially pleased that Robbie O'Malley is here with us tonight, because the Meath players who were supposed to come and accept their awards had a little bit of difficulty on their return journey from the Canary Islands. They had a flight difficulty on the way. Now, let me tell you, at the Bank of Ireland, what did they do? Well, they chartered a plane to go out and to meet them. Now, some of the players have been able to make it, unfortunately, some have not. Obviously, Robbie has been able to make it with us tonight, but more about that later on. Next, we move to the fullback position, and it's a second award for a player who had to overcome injury last summer before regaining his place on his county team as they went through the championship. We're talking about Colman Corrigan from Cork.
Well, what Meath can do, Cork can do likewise. Colman has just returned from the Canaries also, where the Cork squad has been taking a well-deserved break. There being congratulated by Um Taoiseach and receiving his award from Mr. Frank O'Rourke.
Left fullback goes to another newcomer to the All-Star roster, even though this year, in actual fact, he will be 10 years playing for his county senior team. He is one of the most dependable of defenders, and we're talking about Mick Kennedy from Dublin.
A senior footballer with an excellent track record, Mick Kennedy. All the more remarkable, therefore, when you consider that this is just his first All-Star honour. He's been around for a long time, and it's an award that I know that everybody in football will be glad to see him get.
The right halfback is getting his second consecutive award. He's also played elsewhere in defence last year, but in any position, he is one of the most inflexible and tenacious of defenders, Niall Cahalan from Cork.
Yes, Niall Cahalan from West Cork, and in spite of a couple of championship games in the full back line, the selectors nominate him for the second year in succession at right half back, the tight marking Niall Cahalan. So Niall makes his way up onto the rostrum.
The centre half back is another getting his first award here tonight. Now, he made his debut in 1985 and has since proven to be an exceptional defender of great fire and determination. Noel McCaffrey from Dublin.
Dr. Noel McCaffrey, and if ever a player were blessed with the vision to see moves develop before others have appreciated the possibilities, then surely that is Noel McCaffrey here, his first All-Star. And a very delighted Noel McCaffrey.
Well, now, at left half-back is a player who had an outstanding year both in the league and the championship. He surpassed anything that he had previously done for his team. Indeed, perhaps Meath might not have retained the championship without his efforts. Unfortunately, he was one of those who did not make it onto the Bank of Ireland chartered flight to be with us tonight. However, a round of applause for Martin O'Connell of Meath.
A great pity indeed that Martin can't be here to pick up his All-Star. He'll get it later on, of course. As Michael said in the All-Ireland final, he played the proverbial blinder. The game of his life.
Well, next we move to the midfield position, and this position it goes to a player who discovered perhaps new resources in his play last year, and that was Shea Fahey of Cork. Now, unfortunately, Shea can't be with us here tonight, because Shea at the moment is Captain Fahey, and he is serving with the United Nations forces in the Lebanon. But if he can't be with us, well, we were able to go and visit him and see his All-Star Award being presented to him by the commander of his unit, that is Lieutenant Colonel Pat McMahon, himself a former Louth footballer.
Shea, it's a great pleasure for me to be asked to make this present to you, this Bank of Ireland All-Stars Award, for your major contribution to the Cork team during 1988. And I know that I speak on behalf of all my colleagues in the Defence Forces, and indeed on behalf of all ranks, and indeed on behalf of the members of the 64th Irish Battalion serving with United Nations here in South Lebanon, in saying my heartiest congratulations. Co-Gardigans.
Thank you. And a fully deserved honour for a player who delivered consistently game after game in
Thanks
last
very much
year's
for
championship.
For making this presentation. I'd like to say hello to you all tonight at home in the Burlington. I hope you're all enjoying the night so far, and I'm sure you're all enjoy the rest of the night as well. It's a great pleasure for me to accept this award, the Bank of Ireland All-Star Award, particularly here in Lebanon, where I'm away from home for 6 months, and it means in many ways twice as much to me here as it would as if I was getting it at home. There's a number of people I'd like to thank for their help throughout 1988. In particular, I would talk about the members of Nemo Rangers Football Club and the Cork Senior Football Team, and also, of course, Billy Morgan. They helped me in many ways throughout the year, and I wouldn't have got this award without their help. Also, there's Jackie in Cork, who was with me through the good and the bad times all through the year. Lastly, I'd like to finish up by thanking and particularly my parents who are in the
Mum and Dad, Fahey are down there on the table.
Well, the other midfielder has always shown I'm not too sure if that round of applause is for Shea Fahey or for me, but thank you nonetheless for whichever. I was about to say, the other midfielder has always shown a large measure of elegance in his football, and indeed he scored one of the most spectacular goals of 1988. It's his first All-Star award. Now, I also gathered that at the moment he is circling around someplace in the stratosphere with a chartered flight from the Bank of Ireland, Liam Hayes of Meath.
That means an awful lot to sports journalist Liam Hayes tonight, picking up his Bank of Ireland All-Star Award, and he'll be getting that a little bit later on.
I should mention that the Meath players that have not been able to be with us so far are actually trying to get here tonight, so we may see them later on. Now, we move to the left half forward, and that is one of the most effective forwards in the game today. And this is his second successive All-Star Award. It just comes, in actual fact, in time to mark his 28th birthday, which comes up in 11 days' time. We're talking about Kieran Duff of Dublin.
One of the game's up-and-coming stars. Well, brother, this is Kieran Duff that we're watching now. Kieran Duff picking up his second honour in succession.
We are moving a little bit across the way, if you like, right now, because we're trying to accommodate the slight change in our schedule to accommodate the Meath players. We move now to the right half forward and another debutant, and indeed the youngest of the award winners here tonight. He turned 19 just 2 months ago, but he's already made a big impact in 1988, both for his county, for his university, and for his province, and that's Maurice Fitzgerald of Kerry.
And Maurice picks up an award for Kerry. Maurice, who was deadly from freeze and play in the Munster final. But he really does seem destined, doesn't he, for a great career in senior football. He should be introducing him to Mr. Frank O'Rourke.
The centre half-forward award goes to a player who has contributed more than most to his team's present in the last two All-Ireland finals. He's also a leading place kicker in latter times in Gaelic football, and we are, of course, talking about Larry Tompkins of Cork.
Yes, a very modest footballer, Larry Tompkins, certainly a fine object lesson for young players everywhere. Would you consider the amount of extra training that Larry puts in to be as good as he is? And nobody, I'm sure, would begrudge him an All-Ireland medal, perhaps this year.
Now, Kieran Duff, we've already met, of course, so we're going to move forward now to the right full forward position. He had one of his best years of the 14 that he's been in senior football. Now, he scored some of the championship's best long-range points, as I'm sure you'll remember, and it's his first award since 1983. Unfortunately, he is not with us at the moment. That is Colm O'Rourke of Meath.
Well, perhaps we get a chance to see him a little bit later on. As Michael said earlier, they're making valiant efforts to get here, and certainly Colm, a man who could be depended upon in a crisis.
The full forward, and this is another superb marksman of the present day. Indeed, it was his deadly accurate place kicking, unerring even under a great amount of pressure, which sent the All-Ireland final to a replay. I'm delighted to say that he is with us, Brian Stafford from Meath.
And Brian Stafford, a master of consistency, and it's good to see him. A vital cog indeed in the Meath machine. Brian brings to five the Royal County representation in this year's team.
The left full forward is the only player here tonight getting his third award. It was his first, in fact, as a corner back, and that was back in 1979. But he's still showing, I think, the same enthusiastic commitment now as a corner forward. That's Eugene Hughes from Monaghan.
The fact that all five players have now been honoured as backs and forwards in their careers as All-Stars, and nobody did more than Mudie, I think, to help Monaghan regain the Ulster title last summer. He'd love to regain it again this year.
So there they are, ladies and gentlemen, 12 in actual fact, of our 15 award winners here tonight. And let's salute them, ladies and gentlemen, the Bank of Ireland GAA Football All-Stars for 1988.
Five Meath men, four from Cork, three from Dublin, two from Monaghan, and Maurice Fitzgerald from Kerry. And some delighted faces there of the Bank of Ireland All-Stars. Maurice Fitzgerald there on the right with a little wink for everybody, and the smiling Larry Tompkins. And receiving a very enthusiastic response here from the crowd. Well, still to come, the announcement live of the All-Star Hurling team for last year, and we'll be meeting the recipients of the All-Time All-Star Awards. That will be right after the break. Don't go away.
Welcome back again, ladies and gentlemen. Well, now, earlier this evening, we were talking, in fact, about the history of the All-Stars, which was first introduced in 1971. And I suppose it often raises the question of who might have been honoured if these awards had been in existence long before that. Well, we would have had some legendary names for sure. But even if there were no All-Stars to honour the great players of other days, well, perhaps we can redress that balance somewhat here tonight. Each year, the All-Star Committee are given the opportunity to select a footballer and a hurler from the past to present them with our special All-Stars Award. Well, to announce this year's recipient is the Secretary of the Steering Committee of the Bank of Ireland All-Stars, and he's also my RTE colleague. Would you welcome, please, Mick Dunn.
Thank you, Michael. Taoiseach. Books are on coming out last gale, agus cordia illig. Well, once again, the journalists who are associated with the Bank of Ireland All-Stars would like to reiterate that in choosing the all-time All-Stars, we picked men we're sure would have been honoured more than once if there had been All-Star awards in their own playing days. Our football personality this year could have earned hurling awards as well as several for football, because he was recognised as an outstanding dual player, and at 16 he played minor for his county at both hurling and football. He also won county championship medals at both sports, and the summer he turned 19, he made his debut on the county's two senior teams. He never won an All-Ireland medal, but he got to the final in hurling, not in football, however, having been stopped twice at the semi-final stage. Chosen for his province as a dual star, he once played two semi-finals on the same afternoon in Croke Park, and indeed, as did a former all-time all-star in the very same two matches, Jack Lynch was in the same two games. He has four Railway Cup medals, and he was one of a set of dazzling and electrifying forwards who contributed to their province's first triumph in Railway Cup football. So I'm pleased to announce that tonight we're honouring Antrim's Kevin Armstrong.
And a big cheer for Kevin Armstrong, the former dual star from Antrim. Kevin, incidentally, is the third successive Ulster man to be honoured as an all-time All-Star in football. Receiving his award there from John Dowling, president of the GAA, and Taoiseach wants to offer his congratulations as well. And indeed, Mr. Frank O'Rourke.
The hurler being honoured occupies a very special place in his county's illustrious history, not only as a marvellous cornerback who holds three All-Ireland medals, but also because he was the very first of one of the country's most famous clubs to win an All-Ireland medal. That was away back in 1928, the year he first played senior inter-county championship. With his renowned club, he won no fewer than seven county championship medals, all of them in successive years, as it happened. And during his playing days, he also found time to serve that club with devotion as their secretary for a period. And he was later a Cork selector, in fact, also for many years. He got two more All-Ireland medals, and he figured in what's probably been the most dramatic of all hurling finals. Indeed, he's the only surviving member of the team that eventually won that decider. He has both a National League medal and one for the Railway Cup. And he was chosen for Ireland for the Taltian Games of 1932. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome the hale and hearty 85-year-old Paddy Fox Collins of Cork.
And that's one of the biggest cheers of the night, accompanied by his son Tom, also a fine hurler. Fox, I can tell you, is a very lively 85-year-old, and he still follows the fortunes of his beloved Glen Rovers in Cork. Indeed, his son Tom there is a former player.
Well, now, ladies and gentlemen, we certainly couldn't let our two special award winners go without taking the opportunity to talk to them about their playing days. A little bit earlier on, Gerard Canning got the chance to meet with both men.
Paddy, you're this year's all-time All-Star. Have you ever been known as anything else other than Fox Collins? No. Except when I was younger and when they didn't know my name.
Yeah.
Like Don Ron Carey told me, I used to spend most of my time with Ronnie Patrick.
But when you were clearing a ball out of the Cork full back line, they always called Fox Collins, did they?
Yeah. Of course, they didn't know my name, maybe.
When did you come on the Cork senior hurling team? When was that about? 1928?
28, 29. It was the 7th, 28.
And then you lost the 1930 championship. In fact, you didn't even get to the Munster final.
Clare won, I think. Clare won. Beat us in 1930. I believe I won it. I think Tipperary won it that year.
Now, in 31, you enjoyed a fabulous success. Having got out of Munster that year, you met Kilkenny in the final. Was there little or nothing between the teams all the way along? Were the two very evenly matched teams?
I think we won well the last match. We won by a couple of goals, I think. Of course, Laurie Mayer was the man at the time, centre fieldman. Laurie Mayer. There was O'Reilly played. There was two Duns, Johnny Dunn and Dan Dunn. Well, they were all fairly good.
What did hurling mean to you? Was it the most important thing in your life, was it?
Hmm?
Was it the most important thing in your life?
Yeah, it was.
Well, listen, congratulations to you. You richly deserve to be the all-time All-Star for 1988-89. Well done.
It's a great honour, all right, but I don't think I did not get it.
I certainly do. Well done.
It's the greatest moment of my life, the biggest event of my whole career in the GAA.
Well, as we've heard, of course, you were a dual player, a hurler and a footballer. Did that make life very difficult for you?
No, it didn't. I enjoyed both games.
But you must have had some very tiring weeks when you were called upon to play several games at the one time.
Oh, yes. Especially in the summer times, we had midweek matches and maybe two or three matches on a Sunday. It was great.
I can take you back to the 40s now. I know you were the last captain of an Antrim winning football team in 51, but in 46 you had a particularly good team. You won the Ulster title that year.
It was the greatest Antrim team to my liking, you know. Very good.
You beat Cavan in the Ulster final.
I beat Cavan in the Ulster final. Good Cavan team with John Joe and Mick Higgins and Big Tom and the rest of them.
And in the All-Ireland semi-final, I think you played Kerry.
We had a good Kerry team. Joe Cahan and Paddy Candy, Bill Casey, Terry O'Connor and Jackie Lane, all that crowd. They were good men.
What's the story you were telling me about playing for suitcases?
We played Cavan after they came back from the polo grounds in Croke Park 3 weeks after they won the All-Ireland for a set of overcoats and defeated them.
And you were playing for suitcases too, I believe.
And yeah.
How to equip yourself.
Good
well.
Prizes.
Kevin Armstrong, all-time All-Star for this year. Congratulations and well done to you.
Thank you very much.
Yes, indeed. Two great men of the past there. Well, now, I tell you this, I sincerely hope that the Bank of Ireland did not send out a second chartered flight to collect the rest of the Meath men, because if they did, I'll be getting one of those dear valued customer. It's time that you paid the rest of the money that you owed us. Nonetheless, I will have to say that we are delighted to say that the other three Meath players are with us here now. Remember that we were waiting for the left half-back, and that was Martin O'Connell.
So the three wise men are on their way.
We also have our other midfielder has joined us. That is the very elegant Liam Hayes.
Elegance indeed on and off the field, Liam Hayes. Good to see you too, picking up your All-Star award. And I know it's a moment he wouldn't have wanted to have missed.
And last, but by no means least, the man with a permanently gammy right leg, it would appear, but the other one works very, very well indeed. That's Colm O'Rourke.
Nothing wrong about that gammy leg at all, as they'll tell you in Cork. Colm, the great-hearted footballer, greeting and being greeted, and now accepting his award for 1988.
Well, soon then, we will have the announcement of the Hurling All-Stars for 1988. Who will be the 15 honoured players this time? Well, we shall see.
And indeed, we'll have the announcement of the Bank of Ireland All-Star Hurlers very shortly. That'll be right after this commercial break.
And you're very welcome back again. Well, now, although the football and the hurling All-Star Awards are obviously of equal merit, I'm sure nonetheless that the football recipients won't mind me saying that we now come to the highlight of the night. Because the hurling All-Stars for 1988, which is still a closely guarded secret, are about to be revealed. Now, before we do that, let's perhaps just remind ourselves of some of the images and the scores which were the highlights of last year's league and championship action. Well, now the time has come. It's time to name the hurling All-Stars. And let me remind you once again that nobody knows who the winners are, except, of course, the people who actually counted the votes. Even the committee members who selected the All-Stars don't know, because that was done by secret ballot. So let me tell you, we have some very anxious hurlers backstage right now. Mick Dunn has the all-important details.
And these, in fact, are the sheets that will reveal all. So let's get down to business with the All-Star Hurlers for 1988. We start with goalkeeper, and the nominations, remember, were John Commons, Galway, Ger Cunningham, Cork, and Ken Hogan, Tipperary. And the winner is John Commons of Galway.
So Galway's first All-Star of the night, and after several seasons of highly consistent performances, John finally gets an All-Star award, and one which I'm sure that Ken Hogan and Ger Cunningham will not begrudge him.
Right full back, the three nominations, Joe Hennessy Kilkenny, Sylvie Lennon Galway, and Conor O'Donovan Tipperary. And the winner, Sylvie Lennon of Galway.
Well, he's quite a veteran of All-Star Night now. It's his third award in the last 4 years. Sylvie will be hoping to help Galway to a three in a row this summer, and this is quite a good start. Sporting the maroon dicky bow as well, I notice, Sylvie.
Full back now, and the nominations, Aidan Fogarty, Offaly, Conor Hayes, Galway, and Noel Sheehy, Tipperary. And the winner, Conor Hayes of Galway.
Well, so far it's all Galway. And for Connor, it's his third successive honour, reflecting his own high standing as a fullback in 1988 and the years prior to that. Certainly that was a great year, an outstanding year for Connor Hayes, Galway's captain.
Left fullback, and the nominations were Paul Delaney, Tipperary, Doughty Foran of Waterford, and Martin Hannamy of Offaly. And the winner, Martin Hannamy of Offaly.
A newcomer to the All-Star team. Martin turned in a series of wholehearted displays as Offaly reached the Leinster final for the ninth successive year. The 80s belong to Offaly and Leinster, and the left cornerback spot belongs to Martin Hannamy.
And the nominations for right halfback were Peter Finnerty, Galway, Brendan Keeshan, Offaly, and John O'Connor of Wexford. And the winner is Peter Finnerty of Galway.
Well, Peter was the hot favourite to retain the number five position for the fourth year in succession. Skill, power, pace, and boundless enthusiasm on the field. He certainly got the lot.
For centre half-back, the nominations were Martin Bailey of Down, Tony Keady, Galway, and George O'Connor, Wexford. And here the winner was Tony Keady of Galway.
Tony retains the centre-back spot for the third time. His All-Ireland final display, you'll remember, won him the Man of the Match award. And who's to say there won't be more in the next 12 months for this very popular 25-year-old.
And for left half-back, the nominations were Paul Delaney, Tipperary again, Jerry McInerney of Galway, and Bobby Ryan of Tipperary. And the winner, Bobby Ryan of Tipperary.
Being congratulated by Paul Delaney 2 years ago, Bobby was similarly honoured, and by coincidence, his halfback colleagues were Pete Finnerty and Tony Keady, same as tonight. And Bobby was certainly an inspiring defender for Tip in 88. Big moment for him.
Next, we come to midfield, and here there were six nominations for the two positions. The first three, in alphabetical order, are Colm Bonner, Tipperary, Ger Fennelly, Kilkenny, and Joe Hayes, Tipperary. And the award for one midfield place goes to Colm Bonner of Tipperary.
Getting the pat from his colleague. Two awards now for Tip, following a season in which Colm Bonner demonstrated his ability to be an above-average midfielder, capable of giving the lead.
And the other three nominations for midfield were Pat Malone, Galway, Paul McKillen, Antrim, and George O'Connor, Wexford again. And the winner is George O'Connor of Wexford.
And there's a big cheer, and that's a big boost for someone who puts his heart and soul into every game. George was an All-Star centre-half forward in 1981, but this year he shares the midfield with Tip's Colm Bonner, Wexford's first honour.
Right half forward now, and the nominees are Michael McGrath of Galway, Declan Ryan, Tipperary, and Vincent Tehan of Offaly. And the winner is Declan Ryan of Tipperary.
Well, you can see the tension. The fourth of this year's newcomers, Declan, has demonstrated commitment and class beyond his tender years, I think. Remember, he only came into the Tip side 15 months ago, and now he's a firm fixture.
Centre half forward had these nominations: Kieran Barr of Antrim, Joe Cooney, Galway, and Brendan Linsky, also of Galway. And the winner, bringing the first hurling All-Star to his county, is Kieran Barr of Antrim.
Being congratulated by Joe Cooney, yes, as Mick says, the first ever All-Star hurling award for an Antrim hurler. Even though it had been predicted following his excellent championship form, and the applause you'll gather is warm and spontaneous, you're watching a little bit of history in the making.
Left half forward now, and the nominations were Mark Corrigan of Offaly, Martin Nocton of Galway, and Aidan Ryan, Tipperary. And the winner is Martin Nocton of Galway.
Well, they wait, and Martin brings to six the number of Galway men in the team. His effervescent style endears him to hurling fans everywhere. And tonight, Martin winning his first All-Star, congratulated by An Taoiseach.
And right full forward is next. The nominees here are Pat Fox, Tipperary, Michael McGrath, Galway again, and Aina Ryan, also of Galway. And the winner is Michael McGrath of Galway.
And yet another Galway star is honoured. Michael was All-Star right-half forward last year, and he's been selected at the right corner forward position this year.
It's full forward now, and the nominations, Nicholas English, Tipperary, Noel Lane of Galway, and Brendan Linsky, also of Galway again. And the winner, Nicholas English of Tipperary.
Yes, the smiling Nick, rated the top sports star in the country last year. Nick, the most honoured member of this year's team. That's his fifth All-Star in 6 years. The only year out, by the way, was when he was down injured and couldn't play.
And finally, full forward, and nominated here are Alcan McFetridge of Antrim, Tony O'Sullivan of Cork, and again, Aina Ryan of Galway. And the winner who completes the Bank of Ireland All-Star Hurlers for 88 is Tony O'Sullivan of Cork.
Yes, against stiff opposition, Cork's lone hurling All-Star. Tony, who started the Munster final, was honoured twice previously in 1982 and 1986.
And there you are, ladies and gentlemen, the 15 recipients of the Bank of Ireland Hurling All-Star Awards for 1988. So let's give them a very special round of applause.
Yes, now we know, and as always, you can be sure there'll be much discussion when the Bank of Ireland All-Star Hurling team is considered. Seven Galway men, four from Tip, and lone representatives from Offaly, Wexford, Antrim and Cork. But the big story, Ciarán Barr from Antrim, getting the county's first ever All-Star Hurling honour. Four other first-time award winners, including John Cummins, Martin Hannamy, Colin Bonner, Declan Ryan and Martin Nocton. That's five in all. And the footballers, of course, having picked up their honours earlier in the programme, it's a big, big occasion for them. And it certainly has been a terrific night for the game's top hurling and footballing stars. We hope you've enjoyed it. Just before we go, can I remind you that our next sport on Network 2 is Sports Stadium tomorrow afternoon, featuring rugby, Ireland against Wales from the Cardiff Arms Park at 2:30, followed by a recording of England against Scotland in the Calcutta Cup. That's at 4:10. That's tomorrow. Meanwhile, tonight has belonged to the GAA All-Stars, honoured live at the Burlington Hotel in Dublin. Thank you for joining us. Hope you've enjoyed the programme. And until the next time, a very good night to you all. Bye-bye.